Okay, so it's all but been confirmed that the new prominent gay character in the DC Universe is the re-envisioned Golden Age Green Lantern Alan Scott. So this again falls in the long line of things they've done with him to try to keep him more current. Since I've been reading comics, he's been killed, brought back from the dead, de-aged, re-aged, de-aged again, depowered, re-aged. His wife sold her soul to the devil to become de-aged. His daughter died and then came back from the dead. His son became a cosmic shadow egg and then he came back. He was the head of a secret government installation. He was the ruler of an emerald city on the moon where magical creatures lived. He was crippled and stuffed into a giant lantern suit and then killed again. So now to bring him back on Earth 2, where he's going to be the more prominent character on the secondary Earth of the DC Universe. So I don't know if they'll tweak him, because initially he was referred to as the Keeper of the Emerald Flame, and his weakness was wood. I'm assuming they'll probably tweak that, because that would just invite an absolute ton of jokes. That also means that his children, Jade and Obsidian, kind of puts their lives in absolute, complete, and total limbo. Which people ask, do they still exist in the new continuity? Because if Jade doesn't exist, but everything from Green Lantern's moved on, Jade played a prominent role in Volume 3 of Green Lantern, as did Obsidian at some point, as well as Blackest Night and Lost of Jeff Johns wrote, that would affect Volume 4 of Green Lantern. So it just seems really bizarre to a character who's been married for a very, very long time, and who has kids in the previous continuity, and then just kind of go, oh, he's our new gay character.